nasty poacher. Dick hated working for him. He did horrible things to beautiful beasts. Oh. It was during those days that Dick first saw a knapsack. It'll be nice to see one used for good. We have arrived. Deke enjoys coming here to watch the beasts, especially the Puffle of Puffskeins nearby. It would be nice to keep them safe. All you will need to do is get close, direct the open knapsack toward the Puffskein, and in it'll go.
All right. Hello, Deke. Can you remind me how to use the knapsack?
First, get close to the beast you wish to rescue. Then, point the mouth of the bag directly at the beast and open it. The beast should go right in.
Levioso!
Hello, Deke. Can you remind me how to use the knapsack?
First, get close to the beast you wish to rescue. Then, point the mouth of the bag directly at the beast and open it. The beast should go right in.
I managed to rescue a Puffskein.
You can rescue as many as the knapsack will hold. Poachers capture Puffskeins and, well, Deke isn't sure what they do with them. Deke is certain they will be safer with you. Now, not all beasts will be as simple to rescue as a Puffskein. Deke suggests you next find a beast that can fly. A Jobbernoll, perhaps.
All right. Where would I find one?
Deke knows of some to the west, nesting in a large tree overlooking Hogwarts. But we must be careful. Deke has seen poachers in the area recently. Deke will meet you there whenever you're ready.
Hello, Deke. Shall we continue?
Oh, good. Deke was worried about you, what with all the poachers in the area. Perhaps we should work quickly. The Jobbernolls are just here, in this large tree. If it's helpful, Deke has seen Levioso used to slow-flying beasts. Easier to get in close and use the knapsack.
Then I shall go and rescue a Jobbernoll.
Good luck. Deke will be waiting.
I rescued a job and all.
Deke hopes your job and all finds the knapsack nice and cosy. Poachers want them for their feathers, and are not kind when they gather them.
Are there any other beasts nearby?
Just one that Deke knows of, a herd of moon calves. They live in a clearing of trees up this footpath. Deke will see you there.
Hello, Deke. Is this the clearing you mentioned?
It is. Moon calves gather near the large tree with the spiral pattern in front, but only under the light of the moon. So, unfortunately, unless you have a way to hasten time, you might sometimes have to wait until nightfall to see them.
I shall go and find a moon calf then.
Deke, we'll be waiting for your return.
How nice to see you, my young friend.
Thank you. Levioso.
It was a bit trickier than the others, but I have a mooncalf now.
Another beast, safe and sound. Shame we didn't see the mooncalves dancing. It's a marvellous sight. Deke supposes you're finished here. He'll be able to rescue many more beasts, but for now, let's bring the ones you've gathered back to the room.
All right.
Deke will meet you back in the room whenever you're ready. There you are. Now, we need to show the beast you rescued their new home. But, not enough room to let them out here. Imagine all those beasts running amok. That wouldn't do at all. Perhaps if you focus on what your beasts need, the room will provide. What exactly did you think of? Heavens! You've done it!
But what is it?
Deke isn't sure. Only one way to find out. Meet you inside when you're ready. Look at this! It's amazing!
Where are we, Deke?
It seems to be a place for your beasts to live, a vivarium of some sort. Oh, your beasts will be quite comfortable here. They'll live healthy, safe lives. Perhaps you want to release them, let them see their new home. Deke thinks the vivarium will be a fitting new home for your beasts.
Indeed. I only hope we'll have enough space for all of them.
Deke hopes so too. But if you do run out of room, Madam Peck at Brood and Peck in Hogsmeade will help to find safe homes for them.
Any beasts that the room can't hold?
Yes, she's well known for helping to care for beasts in need, and she'll give you a fair price for them. Speaking of care, beasts that are well-fed and groomed will provide you with valuable magical materials, such as puffskein hair, for example. If you gather some magical materials from your beasts, Deke can show you how to use them.
Very well. I shall let you know when I have some. How will never believe this?
Leviosa.
Hello, Deke. I have some questions for you.
What do you need to know?
Thank you. I'll get back to collecting materials.
Wonderful. Good luck.
I've collected some magical materials, Deke.
Now Deke can show you how to use them. First, you'll need to use this spellcraft to conjure an enchanted loom.
An enchanted loom?
Exactly. It will allow you to use your magical materials to weave magic into the very threads of your clothing, making your clothing more useful in a variety of ways. Why don't you try it? Deke thinks you'll be impressed with what the loom can do.
I'll go and experiment with the loom now. Professor, I have some questions about conjuration.
Yes?
There are so many choices. What items do you think I should conjure?
I shall leave that entirely up to you. This is your space, after all. I will say that a simple addition, such as a wall hanging or a portrait, might make the space feel unique.
I think I can manage from here. Thank you.
I look forward to seeing your work.
Revelio. Lumos. Leviosa.
Thank you.
Came out nicely. I should show Deke. I used the enchanted loom, Deke.
Wonderful.
Will I be able to weave even more powerful magic into my clothing with the loom?
You will, by rescuing even more powerful beasts. For now, however, Deke suggests you explore the vivarium and get to know the beasts you've already rescued.
Thank you for your help, Deke.
Meet me near the ruins of Falbatten Castle. After dark, do not tell anyone.
Thank you. for us, we have Professor Weasley. Professor Black glanced at me the other day in the Great Hall. I spit out my breakfast. Not sure it sent the right message.
I hated learning banishment. Never had such abysmal marks.
How rare a metamorphoma guy anyway. I used to like transfiguration, but now it seems to be getting awfully complicated. The most I've ever been able to conjure was a single quill. Not sure I'll ever master that one.
Transfiguration requires such precision. I once turned my pet rabbit into a candlestick. Mother was furious when she set the table and it hopped away.
I managed to conjure a hedgehog once, but it disappeared after a few minutes. Shame. Everyone knows you can't conjure food. Haven't you heard of Gamp's Law?
I'm dreading taking my transfiguration owl. Absolutely dreading it. I'd rather jinx myself than have to explain reasons for the exceptions to Gamp's Law.
I asked Ronan what he'd recommend for a billywig sting, and he laughed and said, try not to be seen. I don't find that funny at all.
The only place I'm able to concentrate is in the library. It's also somewhat exciting waiting for the inevitable breach of silence.
I wouldn't say Professor Howen has a particular affinity for beasts, but she's certainly knowledgeable. I imagine that's why she teaches the class.
I suppose in all fairness, one should be prepared for anything.
It's impossible to do all of the homework they give you. I think they do it all.
Revelio! Revelio. If only Black.
Find anything yet?
Can I help you?
I believe you can. I'm Sophronia, by the way. And I need help from someone who's at least a fifth year. Are you familiar with Herodiana Byrne? Don't answer that. Of course you're not. No one seems to know of her but me. She's only the single greatest Depulso master of all time. Even taught at Hogwarts, briefly.
How interesting. I'm amazed I've never heard of her.
It's a travesty she's not more well known. I often read about great witches in my limited free time. There are many. Whilst reading about her, I learned that she built a secret Depulso training room here at Hogwarts. But in typical clever Herodiana fashion, one cannot access it unless one knows Depulso, which of course, third years aren't taught.
And you're a third year, so...
Quick one, aren't you? According to what I've read, her signature outfit may still be there. I would love to see it. Would you get Herodiana's signature outfit and show it to me?
If you tell me where to go, I'll see what I can do about it.
Simply go to the Hall of Herodiana. It's at the base of the Defense Against the Dark Arts Tower. There, you'll find a series of Depulso puzzles, concealing pieces of Herodiana's ensemble.
Very well. I shall let you know if I find anything.
I can't wait to see Herodiana's famous ensemble. Perhaps I'll make myself a copy.
Suppose I should look for that secret hall Sophronia told me about. It does sound interesting.
What was the Ministry thinking? Blackmailing a bunch of children? He hates children. My parents were thrilled to hear that Black was being British.
Ugh!
Leviosa! Leviosa!
Accio! Revelio! This must be the entrance to the Hall of Well, here it is. The Hall of Herodiana. Better go inside and find those puzzles. Now to see if Herodiana Burn was as good as Sophronia said she was.
Huh?